Christian Abba at the request of the Fisher family. I resolve to know nothing while I live with you except for Jesus Christ and in him crucified.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess, Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to our lasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. May the priest, St. Paul, whose only love was the cross, obtain for us your grace, O Lord, so that urged on more strongly by his example, we may each embrace our own cross with courage. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, sin must not reign over our immortal bodies so that you obey their desires. And do not present the parts of your bodies to sin as weapons for wickedness, but present yourself to God as raised from the dead to life, and the parts of your body to God as weapons for righteousness. For sin is not to have any power over you, since you are not under the law, but under grace. What then? Shall we sin because we are not under the law, but under grace? Of course not. Do you not know that if you present yourselves to someone as obedient slaves, you are slaves of the one you obey, either of sin, which leads to death, or of obedience, which leads to righteousness? But thanks be to God that although you were once slaves of sin, you have become obedient from the heart to the pattern of teaching to which you were entrusted. Freed from sin, you have become slaves of righteousness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Had not the Lord been with us, let Israel say, had not the Lord been with us, when men rose up against us, they would have swallowed us alive when their fury was inflamed against us.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Then would the waters have overwhelmed us, the torrent would have swept over us then would have swept the raging waters. Blessed be the Lord, who did not leave us a prey to their teeth.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
We were rescued like a bird from the fowler's snare. Broken was the snare, and we were free. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Alleluia! The master of the house had known the hour when the thief was coming, he would
said, Lord, is this parable meant for us or for everyone? And the Lord replied, who then is the faithful and prudent steward whom the master will put in charge of his servants to distribute the food allowance at the proper time? Blessed is that servant whom his master on arrival finds doing so. Truly I say to you, he will put him in charge of all his property. But if that servant says to himself, my master is delayed in coming, and begins to beat the men servants and the maid servants to eat and drink and get drunk, then that servant's master will come on an unexpected day and at an unknown hour, and will punish the servant severely and assign him a place with the unfaithful. That servant who knew his master's will, but did not make preparations nor act in accord with his will, shall be beaten severely. And the servant who was ignorant of his master's will, but acted in a way deserving of a severe beating, shall be beaten only lightly. Much will be required of the person entrusted with much, and still more will be demanded of the person entrusted with more. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
That's why they say ignorance is bliss. Sometimes when we don't know these things, then how can we be accounted for them? We're responsible to them. But the more we know, the more we understand, the more there is an obligation to us to follow through. When you and I know things about the physical world, we're very conscious about everything that we do. We're careful with things. We try to make sure that we avoid anything that would harm our physical body, our home, our family, our possessions. We understand these things. We have learned, and sometimes we learn the hard way, but we have learned from them and we take care of those things. In the same way, in the spiritual life, we have a responsibility to take care of our spiritual body, called the soul, and to make sure that nothing harms it or puts it in complete jeopardy for which it was created. So God has given us all of these opportunities for us to respond. It's important that we discover this. You know, the kingdom of God is among us right now. And the important thing for all of us is to discover it. God has done everything. He's established his reign. He has allowed his reign to dwell within us perfectly through his son, Jesus Christ. And how you and I have encountered that person of Christ in the celebration of the sacraments. You know, the sacraments are very real, aren't they? They're encounters with the risen Lord. That encounter is very real. It's not just a kind of a symbol of an encounter. It really is an encounter. And that's what's so beautiful and very efficacious for us. You know, it is a real encounter. And you and I have to place ourselves in the midst of it and to allow that encounter to be really efficacious. Does it take a little bit of work on our part? Surely, because we have a body and a soul, and we have to make sure that we respond to that encounter. So it does take a little bit of our part. But God has done all of these things. God has established everything, accomplished everything so very well. And yet the hard part of it is to discover it among us. Why do we discover the evil that's among us? But we can't always grasp and identify the good, the kingdom of heaven. Even people have a difficult time in saying that. The kingdom of God is here.
among us right now, surely not fully realize, but God is living and breathing and acting right now in our midst. You and I, with faith, can understand that and can dive into its mystery. Because of the powerful cross that has conquered evil and that has destroyed death and restored life, and that for all of us, he has given us redemption and salvation. You know, when I think of that, by Christ's death on the cross and his glorious resurrection, he has bestowed redemption and salvation to all of us. And now we have to respond to it. We need to discover it. And when we respond after we have discovered it, how beautiful all of that is. The ascension of our Lord into heaven. And I think this will help us to understand it a little bit better. When our Lord died and rose from the dead, and then he ascended to the right hand of the Father in all glory, he took us with him. He took us with him when he ascended. And our place is there, already done, accomplished, prepared. He's just waiting for us. And that's where our free will comes into play here. That you and I have to make a decision based on faith. So everything has been accomplished. It's not our work. It's for us to cooperate with his work. See, that's where the heresy of Pelagianism comes in. You've heard of that. We even get our English word when someone plagiarizes from another person. It's something very wrong. If you plagiarize and you didn't note the footnotes at the bottom of your term paper, it's something immoral. Well, there's something in our own faith that tells us that it's not about us. Because everything we do is really a gift and a grace from him. It's his work. We just need to cooperate with it or to say yes to it. And that's very important. So when I think of the ascension, I think of the beautiful gift of faith that he took us with him. He took all of us with him, and he's just waiting for us, waiting for our response, our discovery, and that's important. That's important to know. Today, the church celebrates an optional memorial of St. Paul of the Cross. I'm sure you've heard of him many times. St. Paul of the Cross, a priest, founded the community called the Passionist Fathers and Sisters. They're really a monastic group, but they do active work in the world, but they're mostly a monastic group under the enclosure of a monastery. They also do retreat work. And of course, their charism, or their way of life, is to fall in love with the cross, because it's the cross that has won everything. Without the cross, there would be no salvation, no redemption, no resurrection, no ascension, and the gates of heaven would be closed. So with the cross, there is everything. And I think that's sometimes it's hard for us to grasp it because the cross is ugly. The cross is difficult. The cross hurts. But the underlying meaning of it and the end result of it is glory, joy, fulfillment, happiness, and deliverance from all evil. Well, we could make several retreats just on that and just think about that. Well, today, as the church celebrates this optional memorial Paul of the Cross, we look to him to help us understand everything. I guess that's why the cross is such a beautiful, vivid symbol in all of our churches. You can't shy away from it, can you? It's there front and center. And even when we enter into the church building, we
deliver them and bring them his peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this faith community, may Jesus strengthen us as we seek to build God's kingdom here on earth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, may they be welcomed into the heavenly kingdom by the communion of saints. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, Rory Benzik, Betty and Robert Long, Noel Black, Rita Rico, and all those on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Christian Ah, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for the spiritual and temporal needs of St. Mary's Parish, so that all of us may further the mission of Jesus, like St. Paul on the cross did. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us also pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and in consecrated life, especially for members of our own parish family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the spiritual good of our annual 40 hours devotion this coming Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday. May all of us continue to fall in love with Jesus, the bread of life, the gift of our salvation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they are in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, and the work of human hands, will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine, and the work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink.
Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit.
was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks to your hopeless worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and us, and our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine energy, we dare to say,
"Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil."
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I give you, my peace I give you," look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
We proclaim Christ crucified. Christ, the power of God, and the wisdom of God.